Now to get into the meat of this podcast, I'm going to run through a list to give you a taste of things to come. I'm not going to explain each one in detail because that would take forever. And remember, all of this is in order to answer the question, how do we achieve freedom? To answer that question, we need to understand the following. How to truly live as you wish. Nonviolence, what it means, why it's crucial. And just to clarify, nonviolence does not mean walking around defenseless. Nonviolence means reducing violence as much as possible, preventing violence as much as possible. And by the way, I am strongly discouraging violent revolution. That does not work. It more than likely will result in more aggression and less freedom. So nonviolence is key. Success. What is success? How to achieve success? Why it's crucial to achieving freedom? And just to touch on that, by achieving your own personal success, you can attract others to follow your example and adopt your kinds of ethics, including non-aggression. How to create wealth. By creating wealth, you attract others to the freedom movement. You can also enhance your freedom. The more wealth you have, the more options you have available to you, the more effectively you can live life as you wish. Defense. How do you defend yourself against aggression in general? And this doesn't just include martial arts and gun safety. I'm talking about the whole gamut, situational awareness, danger avoidance, conflict de-escalation, migration, evasion, things of this nature. And once you develop this, you know, strong foundation of and knowledge of how to defend yourself against aggression, then we can tackle the much more complicated issue of how do you defend yourself against aggressors that exist within the government. Because these guys and gals have hundreds of millions of statists and a coercive monopoly on the enforcement of laws and initiating physical force backing them up. It is a situation in which the consequences of your actions are very profound, and we need to address that in a very delicate way with a lot of forethought. Also, we will be covering how to increase our numbers. If we want the freedom movement to become stronger, we need to increase the number of freedom lovers that exist. How do you win hearts and minds? If you've ever tried to convince someone to embrace freedom, you may have experienced how difficult that can be. So we're going to be addressing that. How to effectively connect and collaborate with like-minded people. How to establish a free society. How to assemble groups of individuals, each of which agree on goal, strategy, and location. How to determine the critical mass you are going to need to transform a local culture into a free society. How to develop voluntary alternatives to government services. Agorism, tradecraft, technologies, including cryptocurrencies, 3D printing, etc. Those technologies that can help us achieve freedom. Whistleblowing, migration. How to choose the right location. How to establish a free society on land in an area that is already inhabited by other people. How to do that peacefully in order to prevent tensions between those who are moving in and those who were there originally. How to establish a free society in new frontiers, uninhabited land, on the sea, via seasteading. How to establish extraterrestrial sustainable habitats that are economically viable. Once you have safety in numbers, once you've converged to these areas, the kind of local activism that can be quite effective, nonviolent disobedience, jury nullification, how to purge local aggressors in a peaceful way, how to peacefully dissolve local government, how to determine the rightful owners of local government capital. When someone steals something from someone else, the person who steals it is not the owner of the property. But it's not true that the property has no owner. The property, it still rightfully belongs to the victim from whom it was stolen. And it doesn't matter if the property was money that was extracted and then used to buy other property. The property that wealth was used to purchase is still the property of those rightful owners. If justice is something you value, and I believe that's the case for a lot of freedom lovers, then the best way to achieve justice, you know, once you've dissolved a local government, is not to destroy that government capital or to just auction it off to anyone who comes along. The best way to achieve justice is to return that property to the rightful owners. And I know that process would probably be overwhelming and virtually impossible if we tried to return federal government property to all the citizens of that country. And that's why I really want to start by focusing on the local level and returning the local government property to the rightful owners, because in that case, you can point to the people who are the rightful owners of that property. So how do we determine the rightful owners? And how do we distribute that government capital back to the rightful owners in a way that's fair and just? Once we achieve a free society, how can we defend and maintain that free society, hopefully in a way that's more peaceful, more intelligent, and more effective than the national defense strategies that we observe today? Finally, how can we inspire others to achieve a free society and achieve freedom? And just to share this with you, I don't think it's realistic for us to actively transform an entire country like the United States from what it is now to a free society in one swoop. You know, it'd be great if that happened, but the kind of strategy I'm focused on, and I'd like you to tell me if I'm wrong, is to focus on more localized regions, achieving free societies on a smaller scale. You know, the whole Sun Tzu strategy of avoid your opponent's strength and target weaker areas. So I believe it would be much better to establish smaller scale free societies in areas that have a really low population or no population, and to achieve success in those localized free societies in order to inspire others to either join those free societies or to form new free societies. Through this process, you have these free societies growing and eventually converging together and growing large enough so at some point in the future, they will have the ability to defend themselves against any and all potential aggressors in their region. So, hopefully my rambling over the last several minutes has given you an idea of the types of conversations we will be having. Basically, anything and everything that can help us answer the question, how to achieve freedom, and can help us to achieve freedom is fair game on this program. So that's just a sample of the types of topics we'll be covering. Now, in each episode, I'm going to be giving you a message, or at least that's my plan. The message for today is this: you can achieve freedom. This is not a dream. This is not a theoretical idea that exists in our minds only. This is something that can be achieved. Even if you have a very limited time left in this life, months, weeks, or even days, you can still take steps to increase your freedom dramatically so that you can enjoy each day you have left that much more. If, on the other hand, you're like me, you plan on sticking around for a while, I do believe we have enough time to connect with like-minded individuals and to collaborate in order to achieve that freedom that I've talked about. So we can achieve this in our lifetime, and we can achieve it in a peaceful way. We're not talking about anything that has to do with violent revolutions. Violent revolutions cause innocent casualties, which is a clear violation of the non-aggression principle, and as such cannot achieve freedom. So we can do this in a peaceful way. Action step for today. It's really simple. I want you to subscribe to this audio podcast, and I want you to set yourself up with a way to access audio podcasts no matter where you are, no matter what time it is, no matter what you're doing. And the way I would recommend doing this is to have a smartphone, to have an app on that smartphone, specifically an app that can stream audio podcast episodes directly from the internet through the phone network. The one I use is Pocket Casts. It's good. I recommend it. I don't get any money from them. I'm just mentioning it because it's something I use. But any kind of app that does that, that can stream episodes directly to it from the internet, and that way you don't have to worry about preparing beforehand, syncing your listening device with your computer, or any of that. As long as you have your phone, as long as that phone is charged, you can access valuable content you're interested in. And this is so valuable because not only does it let you make better use of your time, it also allows you to live your life as you wish more effectively. Because imagine if you're waiting in line at the grocery store, is that something you really enjoy doing? If you're driving your car, are you really making the most of your time? If you are sitting at a red traffic light, it's at night, there's nobody around, there's no reason you should have to waste your time, okay? It's this unfortunate situation. Maybe there's a video camera set up and you don't want to get a ticket. Look, you don't have to let the government aggressors force you to waste your time. You can pull out your smartphone and do something you truly enjoy, something that's valuable, accessing content you're interested in. So that's why I recommend that. And I want you to subscribe to this audio podcast because it will allow you to gain access to this information as soon as it's available so that we can make progress toward freedom sooner rather than later. All right, so that is the end of episode one. Thank you so much for listening. I really, really appreciate it. And I look forward to interacting with you in the future, hopefully very soon. The next episode, we will be talking about and doing action steps within the episode to figure out how to live your life as you truly wish. And this is a process that is so incredibly important and I believe incredibly valuable. It will transform your life. It is transforming my life as we speak. I just can't wait to get into that, and I hope you'll join me. So if you need to contact me for any reason at all, go to howtoachievefreedom.com/contact. Leave me a message. If you send me a voicemail over the phone or leave a recording through your computer using your microphone, and you give me feedback or, you know, suggestions or strategies or whatever, anything related to this program, I can then include it in subsequent episodes and we can really get a conversation going. And I hope you'll consider doing that. So, wishing you freedom, peace, and happiness. Enjoy this day. It is one day closer to freedom. One day closer to freedom. Take care.